afraid of no ghosts.
Hey Whitman, I'm Cammy Rogers.
And I'm Sam Berman.
And welcome to a very special Halloween episode of Whitman Shorts.
Hey Cammy, who are you going to homecoming with?
The question is, who are you going to anti-homecoming with?
Wait, there's two homecomings?
Let's go to Kaylin for the story.
Hey Whitman, this is Kaylin Petrides reporting for Whitman Shorts.
If you don't want to dress up as a princess, here are some alternative homecoming ideas.
Go to the zoo, Markov's Haunted Forest, have a Disney movie marathon, bake slutty brownies, go to Pottery Barn and Pottery Barn Kids afterwards, go apple picking, carve Dr. Goodwin's face into a pumpkin, spy on the freshmen, take the ACT, do your college apps, follow Whitman Shorts on Snapchat, go trick-or-treating, rewatch Gossip Girl for the fourth time, rekindle old flames.
Sophia Higgins suggests going to a concert.
So last year for homecoming, I went to a Bastille concert with a few of my friends. I think it was at George Mason University. And we just thought it would be cool to do something different. I would definitely do it again, maybe go to like a smaller venue concert because those are a little bit more intimate, it's more exciting.
Ari Gutman and friends went laser tagging.
Chief, I'm in position.
Copy that, Agent. This is the Chief.
I know you guys can't wait to get in the arena and start playing, but it's important that you listen to this briefing video first.
So last year for homecoming, in the morning we went laser tagging with the group, and then at night we just did like the normal dinner and after party. I definitely think it like makes homecoming a lot more exciting and unique for like your friend group. So if you're like all into sports or something, like maybe go like to a soccer field and play soccer against each other. Or for us, we're all lazy, so we went laser tagging because it's like fun. It's fun and cheap. And yeah, it ended up going really well. Except Claire didn't come.
All right, that's it. Remember your briefing and ask a game master if you have any questions.
Happy homecoming!
Thanks for that. Hey Cammy, what are your thoughts on pumpkin spice?
Let's go to Rachel for the story.
Roll the clip.
Ready, one, two, three.
Wow, pumpkin spice cream Oreo.
It smells like a graham cracker.
It smells like cinnamony.
It smells like a Yankee candle.
Not bad.
It's like a drier version of like pumpkin pie.
That's really bad.
I could see some weird people really enjoying this.
I definitely need to cleanse my palate after this one.
It's like spicy, but it's like sweet.
Yeah, it's pumpkin spice.
I had the whole thing.
Seven?
I rate this like a 4.
Do some little bites.
Because I do enjoy a good little bite muffin.
This is all kinds of incorrect.
A little sticky.
They look really cute.
They're uncomfortably damp.
Yeah, pretty wet.
But it's moist.
It is moist.
It is very moist.
It is moist on the inside.
It doesn't really taste like pumpkin.
I get the spice though.
A solid -3.
I'd give it like a 2.
Pumpkin spice Pop-Tart.
I read on a blog that Whitney Houston's favorite like snack was a Pop-Tart once. I don't know if that's true.
They're better if they're toasted.
Yeah, we don't have a toaster right now, so
I realized that.
That's a funky color.
It tastes like how a pumpkin spice candle is supposed to smell.
I would eat all the borders.
It's really dry.
No one would buy the pop.
Yeah. That's bad.
Don't go.
I was expecting a lot worse, so I'm gonna give it like a 6.
6 out of 10.
Yeah, on the Richter scale, I'd give it like a 3.1.
The Richter scale.
Yeah, I'm like treating it like an earthquake.
These are a 0. I mean, Pop-Tarts in general, I like Pop-Tarts. This ruined Pop-Tarts for me.
Overall, I'm saying, like, I do enjoy pumpkin spice.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah. I would go to Starbucks or something and get, like,
it's definitely, like, pumpkin spice gets a lot of hate, gets a lot of slack.
Definitely
the Oreos were the best.
I'm really not a fan of the pumpkin spice at all. I don't know how these white girls do it all the time, because this is disgusting.
Wow, that's a lot to choose from. You know what I love the most about homecoming?
Probably all the Instagram likes. My favorite is meeting all the cool alumni.
Let's see what Ari has to say about that.
Yes. Whitman, the perfect place to have a conversation with your friends.
It's me, Jackie Mo.
Or nimble on a quick, delicious, healthy snack. Mmm, yum! And of course, new technology. A huge change from the past.
It's what makes Whitman so great. The eagerness to learn, the great food, and the great environment. A bunch of friends having a great time. But have you ever wondered what Whitman was like 40 years ago? Let's take a dash to the past and talk to some alumni about what Whitman was like and how it compares to present-day Whitman today that we all love so very much.
I sat down with Whitman alumni Mimi Neugelborn, who I do not know, about her experiences at Whitman in the past.
So I'm here today with Ms. Mimi Neugelborn. And is this all right if I call you Mimi?
Yeah.
Is that fine? Great. So you went to Whitman, Ms. Neugelborn, right?
I did.
And you graduated when?
1981.
Really? You're that young? So first question for you today. When you went to Whitman, if you could have three words, how would you describe Whitman?
Lockers, Dr. Marco, and everlasting friendship.
That's great. And you have two kids who go to Whitman, right? 9th and 11th grade?
I do.
How are they holding up?
They're doing really well.
But for our final question today, when your kids come home from school and you, as a family, head out to the bowling alley or sit down at the supper table and they're talking to you about school, how would you say it's different from when you went to Whitman back in the late 60s and when they went now?
Well, there's Edline now. And we have Chipotle a lot.
Chipotle a lot. No more brisket or meatloaf.
And there's so many more AP classes.
A lot of more AP classes. They're tough, I've heard.
Very tough.
Very tough. Well, Mrs. Neugelborn, Mimi, I thank you for joining me today and hope to speak to you in the future. And that's the thing. As the Whitman alum brings up, technology has played a huge role in the way school is changing. So let's get a teacher's perspective. We talked to Ms. Hudak, who's been here for over 30 years, about how technology is changing teaching for the good or for the bad.
Has Whitman changed over the years? Oh, yes, it has. Well, first of all, it's a new building. So I taught in the old building. And the old building had the dome, and the dome was amazing. It was very intimidating, but and we used to tell the freshmen that there was a swimming pool under the dome. If they pressed a button, that there was a swimming pool. And all the freshmen believed it was sort of the prank, everybody said. And of course, there was no pool under the dome. Technology has changed how we spend our time as teachers. Technology's added a lot more work to the teaching day. I mean, putting all your grades into the computer, doing your attendance into the computer, doing your lesson plans into the computer, you know, posting things on Edline, posting, I mean, it's added a lot. The big thing about teaching is engaging. Well, if students just have things sent to them, they're not putting a whole lot of effort into it. Another problem with technology is this is your generation, you're so used to looking things up and you do it very quickly and very efficiently that it's not retained.
So it's clear, technology is having a huge impact on school, says Ms. Hudak and our Whitman alum. But how will it be in the future? And will it get worse or will it just get better? Only time will tell. This has been Ari Neugelborn reporting live for Whitman Shorts.
Gonna fly like a bird across the sky.
And we're rolling.
Wow, even more ways to enjoy the fall.
You know what else I love about the fall?
Sports!
Hi, I'm Jake Suskind.
And I'm Zach Salamakel.
Welcome back to Short Center. Let's check out our Whitman sports. Let's first check out my man, Colin Grant, on girls volleyball.
Grant!
Hey Whitman, Colin Grant here reporting live from outside the volleyball practice facilities. I'm ready to get an inside look at how their season's gone so far.
Girls volleyball currently has a record of 4-4 with solid wins over Clarksburg and Walter Johnson. They're looking to get over 500 in their upcoming games and reach the playoffs. I talked to Sar Faruzin about their outlook on the season.
I think the season's going very well. Our record is 4-4. We lost against Churchill, which was pretty upsetting because they're one of our biggest rivals. We have a new coach this season, Erica. She's really good. She helps us work on our technique, and she really helps us individually. I think we're definitely going to go to playoffs because a lot of the matches that we lost this season were all on our errors, and there were just small mistakes that we could definitely work on throughout the season.
Thank you, Grant. Thank you.
Now, time for Trie and Story. Boys and girls, soccer.
Francis, this is Caroline. This is girls and boys, varsity, soccer. Let's do it.
The boys ended their season with a 6-4 record with huge wins over Northwood and BCC. I talked to junior players Evan Cameron and Andreas DeJerhus about the upcoming playoffs.
Definitely different from last year. We have a lot more younger kids this year, but our seniors have really stepped up and provide, you know, good leadership.
I think we got to clean up our defense a little bit, like our organization, but strengths, we've got a great attack and we've got great ball work, possession, and I think with our players, our main players coming back from injuries, our team's just going to keep getting better and better. We want to win states, and we think we can do it, and really that's our plan.
Please come to our games.
The girls' soccer team has been unbeatable this year, with wins over Richard Montgomery and BCC. Key players Kirsten Bissell, Kate Morrison, and goalkeeper Nikki Lane have contributed to both the offensive and defensive surges. I spoke with junior Abby Myers and captain Kristen Bissell about going into playoffs strong.
We're definitely going to try to get back to states. That's definitely a goal. And keep a winning record.
This year, I think that playing consistent, being dominant throughout the whole game of each one we play is important. I mean, we're playing Churchill coming up. It's away, so be there.
Hi, this is Olivia Lobsons reporting for Whitman Shorts. Let's take a look at how the football team has progressed this season.
The football team came out really strong against crosstown rival Churchill, with big offensive and defensive plays from players like Austin DeRamus, Alex Hilgenrath, and George Wilson. The Vikes came out on top, 44-14. I talked to juniors Dawson McKay and Matt Clayton, as well as seniors Austin DeRamus and Alex Hilgenrath after the game.
Our defense really stepped it up, came to play today, really held them to minimal rushes.
We executed our offensive and defensive game plan. We held 22 to not many rushing yards, and we threw the ball, ran the ball pretty effectively.
Now, it's time for Zachary Salem Makel, the man, the myth, the legend, going to do field hockey for Whitman Sports.
Hi Whitman, even though I may be missing my left knee, I'm still gonna bring you primetime sports all the time.
The girls' hockey team is still wrecking it. With a record of 6-4, the girls are continuing to take names. We watched the girls in their smashing victory over Einstein, 9-0. The girls were scoring all over the place, and their defense was unstoppable.
Ellie Gill and Danny Nahabedian were very excited about their big win and are looking forward to even bigger ones. The girls' regular season is coming to a close, so get ready for them to make a big splash in playoffs. This has been Zach Salem-Akel reporting for Whitman Shorts.
Way to go, Zach!
Okay. Well, Whitman, that's it. I'm Zach Salem-Akel.
And I'm Jake Suskind. We'll see you next time.
It's that time of the episode, Whitman.
Time for Speaks.
Hope, you want to see me do something? Hope, watch me. Well, I won't get that hurt, will I? You got me, Ching? Homecoming.
No,
thank you.
No.
If I go to homecoming with you, will you give me a piece of pizza? Really?
Yeah.
I'm having some problems climbing the building, but it's worth it in the end. It's not working. Do you know my name?
Jesse.
False.
How do you feel about the new... Dr. Goodwin just released his new jazz album titled Sensations of the Soul. How do you feel about it reaching top 10 on Jazz iTunes?
I feel like my soul has some sensations, and I think he's great. I really think he's a rising artist on the rise, you know? Rising.
How do you feel about Donald Trump's views on foreign policy?
I don't pay attention to Donald Trump.
I'm voting for him.
Can you guys sing me your favorite summer song? What's your favorite summer song? Never gonna give you up. You and me, Beach House this summer.
I like that idea. Will there be other people, or is it just like a romantic getaway for you and I?
My aunt might come.
Okay, I'd be down.
Speedo or swim trunks?
Speedo. Definitely.
Attaboy.
Well, I've got thick skin and an elastic heart, but sure,
let it... Sam. Yeah.
Well, Whitman, that's it for us this episode.
Have a happy and fun homecoming.
And a spooky Halloween. See you later, Whitman.